Subnormal intelligence. At the very bottom, intelligence works more like instinct. People here often score below 70 on IQ tests, usually due to developmental conditions, genetics, or brain injuries. Life is immediate. Sounds, touches, emotions. Even daily tasks like dressing may require lifelong assistance. Abstract rules or long instructions don't stick, but people here often respond more to tone and kindness. Imagine recognizing frustration in a voice without catching the words. Independence is rare, but connection is real. Deep bonds, simple joys, raw emotions. Society once labeled harshly, but today the focus is on care, support, and dignity. Intelligence here isn't about solving problems. It's about sensing the world moment by moment. Below average intelligence. Step up and things get more practical. IQ ranges from about 70 to 85. Complex math or theory might never click, but hands-on tasks? That's where they shine. Repetition, routine, structure, those are the sweet spots. Jobs with clear steps, like caregiving, customer service, or manual work, can feel natural here. In school, tests are harder, but loyalty and warmth often run strong. Here's the catch. This level is often underestimated. But with support and respect, people here raise families, maintain jobs, and build meaningful communities. Average intelligence. Most people live here, and most assume they don't. Reading, writing, following rules, paying bills. This is the intelligence of daily life. You understand cause and effect, make plans, and usually get them done. Nurses, drivers, business owners. Average intelligence runs society's core systems. Not flashy, but effective. But here's the trap. It feels like the end of growth. People here are smart enough to think they get it, but not sharp enough to see their blind spots. Many people stop asking deeper questions here, not because they can't, but because they never feel the need. Stability is both a strength and a cage. Above average intelligence. Now thought gets faster. IQ scores here range from about 115 to 130. You don't just learn, you leap. You spot patterns others miss, see outcomes forming long before anyone else realizes there's a problem. School can feel like waiting for others to catch up, conversations like buffering. Interests often drift toward coding, philosophy, or engineering, places where complexity feels like home. But here's the shadow. That speed can turn into frustration. You edit yourself mid-sentence as your brain is already on step 10, not because others are stupid, but because they're too slow to sync. If you're not careful, high ability turns into quiet detachment. High intelligence. At 130 to 145 IQ, you're in the top 2%. Thinking here isn't just faster, it's more abstract. You don't just spot patterns, you see the system behind them. These minds don't just learn quickly, they make intuitive leaps. Problems feel solvable before anyone else has even named them. Many dive into advanced science and math. They enjoy logic puzzles, deep discussions, and strategy. But speed isn't always a gift. High intelligence can feel misunderstood or isolated. Emotions lag behind thoughts. Supported, though, these minds become the ones pushing boundaries, inventing solutions, and reshaping what normal intelligence looks like. Gifted intelligence. Gifted usually means an IQ above 145, but it's more than a score. It's how the mind processes depth and originality. Gifted kids often teach themselves piano, design gadgets from scraps, or write stories far beyond their age. Like Nolan Gould from Modern Family, IQ 150, who graduated from high school at age 13. The shadow side? Frustration with slow systems, isolation from peers, or overwhelming emotions that move just as fast as their thoughts. When ignored, they risk shutting down or burning out before their potential ever shows. But when nurtured, this level produces creators, innovators, and thinkers who pull ideas years ahead of their time. It's intelligence that doesn't just keep up with the world, it bends it. Genius intelligence. This is often said around IQ 160 and above. But numbers don't really capture it. Genius means insight that feels alien, ideas that flip entire fields upside down. Think Einstein reimagining time itself by visualizing space-time. Ramanujan seeing math in patterns no one else could touch. Or Stephen Hawking exploring the mysteries of black holes with a mind unbound by physical limits. Early signs in genius kids include self-taught skills like advanced math or foreign languages by age 5. The downside? Genius rarely fits smoothly into schools, jobs, or even conversations. What feels obvious to them often sounds incomprehensible to others. Too radical, too strange, too soon. Polymath intelligence. This level isn't about one domain, it's about many. A polymath learns languages, plays instruments, engineers machines, and writes philosophy, not because they want to show off, but because their brain doesn't draw hard borders between fields. Da Vinci is the classic example. Art, mechanics, science, anatomy, all in one. Benjamin Franklin printed, experimented, governed. Elon Musk is a current example. At this level, intelligence is integration. Math bleeds into music. Biology rhymes with philosophy, but spreading wide also comes with pressure. Society rewards specialization while polymaths thrive by weaving disciplines together. Their strength is in connection, seeing how one truth explains another. Visionary intelligence. Visionaries take it one step further. They imagine futures that don't yet exist, then push to make it real. Nikola Tesla was sketching inventions that arrived decades too early. Steve Jobs reframed technology as art. Intelligence here is less about test scores and more about scale. Taking an abstract picture of what could be and making others believe it's real. It's a double-edged sword. Many visionaries face rejection, ridicule, or collapse. Their ideas seem impossible until they redefine the landscape. But when they land, they alter the direction of history. Transcendent intelligence. This is the horizon, at the highest level, the point where intelligence feels less like personal capacity and more like tapping into something beyond the self. Mystics, sages, and rare thinkers across cultures describe reaching a level where the mind quiets, yet comprehension expands. Think Buddha. Think Socrates. Think Jung. They don't just connect the dots, they question the dots themselves. Transcendent intelligence isn't loud. It's quiet, often mistaken for detachment or madness. Whether seen as spiritual enlightenment, cosmic consciousness, or simply the peak of human potential, this level sits at the edge of what we can describe. So, which level do you think you're at? Or maybe, which one you're slipping into next? Let me know in the comments. I'll be making more videos like this. Subscribe to see them.